Children, so today's first topic is relative density. So the term relative comes when you compare anything, okay? And comparison is done by taking the ratio. So that's why relative density of a body, it is defined as density of the body divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. This one is important. Why? Because density of water at 4 degrees Celsius is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Alright, so here you see this. Why you have to mention this? Because density of water changes. If you change the temperature, then for different range of temperature, density of water changes. So in the definition of relative density, we consider density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, so you see here, relative density, as you are comparing the density of the body and density of water at 4 degrees Celsius, both of them are having the same unit. So relative density has no unit. Then next one is density of the body. One can write like this: mass of the body divided by volume of the body. Let us consider volume V. And then for water also you can write it as mass of water divided by volume, same volume of water. Alright, or you simply you can write it as only volume of water. Just understand that what you have done, we have taken the volume of the body and volume of the water same. Clear? So you see, if you take volume of the body and volume of the water same, so you can cancel it. So how you can rewrite this? You see, mass of certain volume of the body divided by mass of same volume of water. So here, certain volume and same volume. What is the indication? That in both the cases, you have taken the volume of the body and volume of water same. Alright? Now, you can do this. Mass of certain volume of the body, if you multiply it g by small g, which is acceleration due to gravity, then you can write it like this. It is mass of certain volume of the body into small g divided by mass of same volume of water multiplied by small g. What does g represent? This is acceleration due to gravity. Alright? And mass into g is equal to weight of a substance. Weight of a substance is mass into g. So you see, what you can write here, relative density, as there is no space here, I am writing it here. So you see, you can write RD is weight of the body divided by weight of same volume of water. Alright. Now, how you can take weight of same volume of water? Simply you take the body and you immerse it in water. So when you will immerse it in water, then what will happen? The body will displace the liquid or the water of the same volume as that of the body. Means whenever a body is immersed in water, it always displaces the water whose volume is equal to the volume of the body. Okay, it is very easy to understand. You know what is the volume of the body, the space occupied by the body. So when you are dipping the body inside the liquid, then the space that is occupied by the body, that cannot be occupied by water. Means that amount of water, that volume of water, the body will displace. Alright, so this one you can write it as weight of the body divided by weight of displaced water by the body. Okay, so relative density, this relation you have to learn and remember. Relative density is density of the body by divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Why 4 degrees Celsius? Because at 4 degrees Celsius, density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Then, by using all this concept, we have arrived at this last one. So, this last expression also you must learn and remember, that relative density is weight of the body divided by weight of displaced water by the body. And you have to remember this relation also for solving the numericals. That relative density is mass of certain volume of the body into g by mass of same volume of water into g. And so if you cancel g, it will only become the mass of the body, certain volume of the body divided by mass of same volume of water. Next is comparison of densities of three states. Now if you consider solid, alright, for solid, what you can write, density is equal to mass by volume. Alright, now for the same mass, it happens that always you will see the volume of the solid is, it is as it is closely packed, it is less. So solids are generally denser, but if you consider the liquid and gas, the for the same mass, the density of liquid is less than solid, and for gas density is least amount. All right, now if you consider what is the effect of temperature on the density of the solid. So when you are increasing the temperature, all right, then what happens? Mass remain constant. Mass does not depend on temperature. Alright, mass remain constant. But what happens to the volume? Volume increases. So look at this relation. If mass remain constant and volume increases, then what happens to the density? That density decreases. Clear? So, the same concept you can apply for liquid and gas also. For liquid and gas also, what happens? When you are increasing the temperature, mass remaining the same, but volume increases. For liquid and gas, volume increases manifold. So, density decreases by a larger amount. Whereas, in case of solid, volume does not increase by a large amount. That's why there will be a decrease in the density, but not very much. Is that clear? So, what is the effect of temperature on the density? For solid, density will decrease. For liquid also density will decrease, but for gas also density will decrease. But for solid, the density decreases by small amount. Whereas for liquid and gas, the extent is more. So what I said, in case of solid, that solid, liquid and gas, for all the three, if you increase the temperature, then what happens? Volume increases, density decreases. But water behave in a different manner. Alright, how the water behaves? If you consider, if you increase the temperature from 0 degree to 4 degree Celsius, alright, then what happens? You will observe that volume decreases. Alright, in case of solid, liquid, gas, what I said, if you increase the temperature, volume increases. But how water behaves? For water, if you increase the temperature from 0 to 4 degrees Celsius, volume decreases. So, volume decreases means density increases. Is that clear? So you see, in case of water, instead of increasing the temperature, if you cool down water from 4 degree to 0 degree, then it expands, then volume increases. So that is known as anomalous expansion of water. So what is the definition of anomalous expansion of water? Expansion of water when it cools down from 4 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius is known as anomalous expansion of water. This definition is important, you must learn and remember it. Alright, and remember that at 4 degrees Celsius, okay, density becomes maximum and volume becomes minimum. Then after that, after 4 degrees Celsius, if you go on increasing the temperature, then water starts behaving like the other substances. Means from 4 degree, above 4 degrees Celsius, if you increase the temperature, then what will happen? Volume will increase and density will decrease. So these are the very important facts, you must learn and remember it. I am repeating, for water, from 0 degree Celsius to 4 degree Celsius, if you increase the temperature, if you heat up water, then what happens? Instead of increase in volume, volume of water decreases, so density increases, and at 4 degrees Celsius, volume is minimum, whereas density is maximum. And after that, if you increase the temperature, then what happens? Volume start increasing and density start decreasing. So this one, expansion of water when it cools down from 4 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius, you must underline this, cools down, okay, is known as anomalous expansion of water. Now consider this case. Suppose you have taken certain amount of water. It is applicable for all liquid and gas, okay, whatever I am discussing now. And what you have done, you have just added certain amount of blue color, so that you can understand it. Means here you have just placed certain few drops of blue color. Then if you start hitting this, what you will observe, what will happen to the liquid? You see here, the liquid in this place, they are getting the direct heat. So when they are heated up, then what will happen? Volume will increase, density will decrease. Density decrease means it will become lighter. So when it will become lighter, what will happen to the liquid? Liquid will rise up. Alright, hot liquid, it will rise up. Now, what is happening here? When the hot liquid is rising up, then definitely it will just replace the cold liquid here. So, what the cold liquid will do? Cold liquid from these two places, they will come down. Alright, so when the cold liquid is coming down here, this is the cold liquid is coming down. Again it is becoming hot, so it is moving up, and when it is moving up, then from the upper side cold liquid is coming out, coming down. So you see a current of liquid will form here. This is known as the convection current. Alright, means whenever a liquid or a gas is heated, then this is the way the entire liquid or gas heated up. Slowly, alright, means from the central portion the hot liquid it will move up, and from two sides the cold liquid will come down, and means hot liquid is just pushing the cold liquid from both the sides down. Cold liquid is coming down and getting the heat, becoming hot, becoming lighter, moving up, and heavy cold liquid coming down. And this is this way how long it will continue till the entire liquid attain the same temperature. So this is known as the convection current. All right, in our day to day life there are different applications of this convection current. Okay, now you know that near the seashore always temperature is moderate. I hope in geography also you studied it, that near the seashore why we are having a moderate temperature, due to the formation of land bridge and sea bridge. Now this land bridge and sea bridge, these two are the examples of convection current in our day to day life. So if you consider, just you consider this one, that this is water, means near a seashore, this is water and here is land. Okay, now during daytime what happens? When sun rays are falling on land and sea water, water always takes some time to become hot. And near the seashore on the land, what are there? Sands are there, isn't it? So sand becomes hot also faster and sand cools down also faster. So what is happening when the sun rays are falling on it? I will not draw the sun rays. When the sun rays are falling on the land, then what happens? Land first become very hot. So when the land is becoming hot, then the air above the land, it becomes hot. So, and it becomes lighter. So you see, from the land during the daytime, this is happening during daytime. Alright, what is happening? That land is becoming hot faster. So above the land, whatever air is there, it is becoming hot and lighter. So the hot air is moving out. So when the hot air is moving up, what will happen here? Here may be a vacuum may be created, or it may happen the pressure in this region, air pressure in this region, it decreases. Then what will happen? From the sea, comparatively, alright, cold air, they will come to the land. Okay, because cold air is heavy, so what will happen to fill up this space? Cold air will come to land. Clear? So this cold air, it is known as sea breeze. Alright, so during daytime, this is the way sea breeze is formed. Now, during night, what will happen? As I said you already, that during night, land will cool down faster. Land is cooling down, but water is remaining hot. So the water above the sea, now they will move up. So when the hot air will move up, then a low pressure region will be created. Then to fill that one, from the land, cold air will move towards the sea. So this is known as land breeze. So you see, near the seashore always there is a flow of air. During daytime it is sea breeze and during night it is land breeze. So this land breeze and sea breeze, here when it is happening, you see here also there is a convection current, isn't it? Hot air is moving up and cold air is coming from this side. Okay, so this is the way, by the formation of sea breeze and land breeze, near the seashore weather becomes moderate. Next topic is floating and sinking. So if you consider a body within a liquid, then what is happening? That physics first you try to understand. When you are immersing a body within a liquid, then what the body will do? The body will displace certain amount of liquid. Alright. Now you just consider this one, what will happen to that displaced liquid? It will become very angry. Suppose you are sitting in your place and then another girl has come from other section and he that girl pushed you and take your seat. So you are displaced from your seat. Then what will happen? You will become very angry. Then you will just react, isn't it? So here also the displaced liquid, what it does? It exert a force on the immersed body. Alright, so that force is known as upthrust or buoyant force. Now this one, so if you consider a body inside a liquid, then what are the forces acting on it? This is the weight of the body. Weight of the body is acting down, alright, and upthrust, this is known as upthrust. Upthrust exerted by whom? Upthrust exerted by the displaced liquid. It acts in the upward direction. Alright, now these two forces decide when you are just immersing a body inside a liquid, what will happen to the body? The body will float or sink. Alright, now you apply your common sense that there are two forces acting on the body. Alright, so if the weight of the body is greater than the upthrust, then what will happen? The body will come down and means the body will sink. Clear? So you see, what is the condition for sinking? That weight is greater than upthrust. Means downward force is greater than the upward force. Clear? Now, weight of a body, you can find out the weight of a body by this way, volume into density into g. Alright, so you just look at the expression. If the density, weight of the body, it depends on the density of the body. Is that clear? Like that, upthrust, you can write it as volume of, upthrust is equal to weight of the displaced liquid. So upthrust, you can write it as upthrust is weight of displaced liquid. So weight of displaced liquid means volume of displaced liquid into density of displaced liquid into g. Alright, now consider this example. When the body is fully immersed, fully within the liquid, then the volume of the body and volume of the displaced liquid, they are equal. Alright, g also equal. So how W is greater than U? W is greater than U means density of the solid or of the body, anything you can write, greater than density of the liquid. Alright, so what is the condition for sinking? Condition for sinking is weight should be greater than upthrust, which means density of the body should be greater than density of the liquid. Okay, I hope you will understand it. I am verbally saying it properly, although my handwriting is not clear here, but you are understanding what I am saying verbally. So write down properly in the copy. So what is the condition for sinking? Weight is greater than upthrust or density of the body is greater than density of the liquid. Then what will happen? The body will sink. So what is the condition for floating? When W and upthrust, they will be equal, then what will happen? The body neither will come down nor will move up. Okay, means what? It will remain at this position, means it will float within the liquid. So what is the condition for floating? That weight of the body is equal to upthrust acting on the body. So simply you can write down W and is equal to upthrust acting on the body. Again, I have told you, that weight of the body and is depending on volume into density into g, and upthrust acting on the body, it is depending on the volume of the displaced liquid, density of the displaced liquid and g. So when the body is fully immersed, then both the volumes are equal, g equal. So what conclusion you can write? That density of the body becomes equal to density of the liquid. Here remember, when the body is fully immersed. Okay, so what is the condition for floating? Weight equal to up thrust. What is the condition for sinking? Condition for sinking is weight greater than up thrust, means downward force is greater than the upward force.